In this video, we will look at the capabilities of Azure Event Hubs in a simple demo integrating Azure Functions, Cosmos Database, and Power BI. Azure Event Hubs is a data streaming platform that can receive and process millions of events per second. It can be widely used in a variety of IoT applications, telemetry data, and any other big data streaming need you may have. Setting up an Event Hub in the Azure portal is quick and easy. Here we can see we have already navigated to the Azure Government portal. We click on Event Hubs. Here is an Event Hub namespace that we have already deployed. If we navigate to Entities and click on Event Hubs, we can see all of the Event Hubs that we have under this namespace. To create a new one, we click on this. We can fill out the name, modify the message retention rate, as well as a number of partitions to distribute your Event Hub messages. Now let's look at a real-world application. Let's say we have traffic booths in various locations gathering data such as the number and average speed of passing cars. We want to send this data over to our Event Hub. Here we have a simple console application that will send messages directly to our Event Hub. We have navigated to the command prompt so that we can run the console application that we were just looking at. Here we can see we have run the help command, and we can see the different parameters that we need to fill out in order to send a message. So let's send a message. We have set the location to Houston, the speed to 50 miles per hour, and the number of cars to 500. We can see that we have successfully sent the message, and it continues to send the message on a loop to the Event Hub. We have just sent messages to our Event Hub. Now we need to process those messages as events. Here we have navigated back to the Azure Government portal, and we are looking at our function app that has already been deployed. Here is our traffic sensor function that will be triggered when something is written to our Event Hub. The function will then write the events to a streaming Power BI endpoint as well as to a Cosmos database. Here we have navigated to the Cosmos database that our function app has been writing the messages to. If we click on Data Explorer and navigate to the traffic messages collection, here we can see the message that we have just written to the Event Hub, which has triggered our function app to write to the Cosmos database. Power BI is a powerful tool that will allow us to visualize our data. We can build reports and dashboards from live streaming data. In order to do that, we need to create a streaming dataset. Here we will click on the streaming dataset, choose API. Here we have set the name for our streaming dataset as well as the data values that will be sent to our stream. Now let's click Create. Our streaming dataset was successfully created. Now we can grab our streaming endpoint and start sending data. Now we want our function app to write to the streaming endpoint that we have just created. Here we have navigated back to our function app in the Azure portal. If we navigate to the application settings, we can see that there is a setting called Power BI Endpoint. Here we can paste in the URL of the streaming endpoint that we have just created and click Save. Let's create a new Power BI dashboard so that we can visualize our streaming dataset. Hit Create, and we have created a brand new Power BI dashboard. Now let's create a streaming tile so that we can see our data visualizations. We click Add Tile on this top bar, and we can choose the custom streaming dataset. Then we can choose a streaming dataset that we created before. Now we can choose the values that we want for our clustered column chart. We have filled in these values, and now we want to set the time window to display. Let's set it to the last 10 seconds. This will display the data that has been sent to the streaming endpoint in the last 10 seconds. Now let's give this a title. Here we have the streaming tile that we have just created, which is currently empty because we have not sent any messages to our Event Hub after we created our streaming dataset. If we look above, we see Ask a Question About Your Data. This is the Power BI Q&A functionality. This allows users to type in the data points that they want in their visualizations, and Power BI takes care of the rest. So let's say we want to show sensor value by location, sensor ID, for the last 10 seconds. Here we can see that Power BI has created a visualization based on what I've typed into Q&A. By clicking here, we have just changed this to a column chart. Currently, this graph is showing the sum of the values that have been sent to the Event Hub. Let's say we want to just see the average. And let's also filter by sensor type. Here we can choose a sensor type to filter by. Let's choose number of cars. Now we have created a visual that shows the average number of cars in the last 10 seconds. Let's pin this visual to our dashboard. When we go back to our dashboard, we can see the number of cars visual that we have just created. I have also created this average speed visual, which is just the same data filtered by average speed. Now we are going to see everything in action. Here we have opened up our console application to send a few messages. I've set the location to Ithaca, which we currently do not have in our visualizations. We have now successfully sending messages. Now let's look at our visualization. We can see that Ithaca has appeared in our visualizations. Now let's stop these messages. Now I'm going to change the number of cars so that we can see the graph changing in front of our eyes. We're going to put these two side by side so that we can see the visualization. Now we are going to change the average speed. If we take a look at this graph, we can see that the average speed is also increasing. Now let's say we have two instances of our console app running, one with the location set to Ithaca and another with the location set to Baltimore. We have started sending messages for both. We can see that immediately our visualizations are reacting to the messages that we're sending for both locations. Here is another Power BI visualization that I've created from our streaming dataset. It is showing the number of cars by location on a US map. So let's see this data side by side. Here we are going to send messages with a location set to Houston. Here we can see that the values for Houston are continuing to increase. In this video, we have walked through a simple scenario where we are sending sensor traffic data to an event hub, which then triggers a function that will write the data to a Cosmos database as well as to a Power BI streaming endpoint. We have then walked through the different data visualizations you can set up with Power BI. We highly encourage that you navigate to the Azure Government Event Hub sample, where the code for the console application as well as the function app that we have demoed lives. We hope this video has shown you how easy it is to get started with Azure Event Hubs today.